celebrating 15 years of this beloved foolery.
What did you do to the dog?
I don't know. I didn't do anything to this dog.
I'm crying.
Is that a stain on your pants now?
I'm sure he's
I think the best thing you can do is just let him ride it out. And
no! That's the worst thing you can do.
Jeff and Jeremy in the morning on 93.3 KZOZ.
Yes, it's Friday. We got another shot for you to get into the VIP tent at the Central Coast Craft Beer Festival. VIP tickets coming up later. We do know the show. Just listen to this, and then if you're with us at 9:40, we'll ask a question. If you know the answer, call in and you win. It's that easy. Also, John Fogerty tickets at 8:40 this morning.
I think the Strokes were my favorite band in college.
Oh,
looking
yeah?
back on it, I had a lot of favorite bands in college, so I would go back and forth, but it seemed like what I would go back to and listen to the most were the Strokes.
Yeah,
I always like when you play this open.
Cake, Strokes. There was a handful of Smashing Pumpkins. Oh, and I can't. Queens of the Stone Age. Also like them a lot. Of course, I think they came on a little bit later on. So, and there was a really good movement there in the late 90s, early 2000s with some music, alternative. And then there was a really bad movement with like Nickelback, Creed, Hinder, Shinedown.
Yeah. It's like we got a taste of good and then we got bombarded with a tidal wave.
How did it go the wrong way? Yeah, it went to that stupid, simple rock, I guess. I don't know. That
tells you. That's rap rock.
That's who,
It was terrible.
After 31 years on daytime TV, one of my probably my favorite talk show hosts is going to retire. Do you know who it is?
How many years?
31.
Your favorite talk show host?
Yes, and he was in.
I thought Larry King was already retired.
No, it's Maury Povich.
He's your favorite?
He was always my favorite. He was a Current Affair, if you remember. And then he got his own show, and then his show realized it had to be something. And my favorite episode,
the pregnancy test show.
Yes,
that's all.
Yes. And that's one of his favorable moments as well, which I'm going to play it in a minute. But well, here's Maury talking about it. 31 years.
So many of my staff have worked with me for 25, 30 years. My nephew, Andrew Povich, has been with me for 31 years. Oh, he's my director. Cool. Paul Fallhaber has been with me for over 25 years. I mean, it goes on and on. And so I'm going to miss them the most. And in fact, I didn't tear up last week at our final taping until they started. And when they started,
Real men cry, Jeff.
It was a river.
Real men cry. So just remember that.
No, divas cry.
Maury, here's his favorite moment on the show, and it's one of those moments of you're the father type thing.
There is one particular show that's etched in my memory forever, and that is when a woman was accusing a guy of being the father of her twins, and so we have a lot of those, and so I open up the envelope, and you have to understand, one of the things I did very early on, I didn't want to know the result of lie detector tests, DNA tests. I didn't want to know anything more than my guests, my live audience, or the audience at home. And I open up the envelope, and this guy, I say, you're the father of one, but not the other. And I look at my staff and go, what? And they said, it's a million to one shot, according to the scientists, with fraternal twins. If someone is pretty active over 24, 48-hour period, you can have two fathers.
See, my favorite
one in a million pregnancy test happened on Maury Povich's
show. That's
awesome.
That's awesome.
Because I like as many pregnancy tests as he ran as his main content and the lie detectors and all that stuff. Like there still was not that many. I mean, you'd have what, you know, you'd do maybe 100 to 150 shows a year. You did it for 30 years. I mean, that's still the million to one pregnancy test is not going to manifest itself typically on your show, but until it did. Gosh, that's amazing.
The one where he wasn't, he says, you are not the father. And this guy's like, damn. And he had like 10 guys, his whole entourage in the audience. And they're all like, boom. And then they started playing like some kind of like rap music. And they're all like dancing around like, you dirty hoe, you dirty hoe. And then you look at the girl, the woman who swore he was the only one. tears just raging down her face. And all that entertainment and funniness went away like that. I thought that was the best moment on TV that I've ever seen.
Jeff and Jeremy in the morning on 93.3 KZOZ.
Good morning. The big show's coming this weekend. For some of us, it's a big show. Since I was a teenager, I don't think I gave two S's about the Oscars, but it is happening this weekend. And let me just tell you right now, the real award show, the Anatomy Awards with Mr. Skin, will be running down Monday after the Oscars. Who's Will Packer? Do you know who he is? Who cares?
No.
Yeah, but he's some guy running his mouth about the Oscars, and he says he wants to make it feel less inside.
I really feel like this show has felt too Hollywood insider. We're Hollywood. We're the cool kids. That's not the type of show I want to do. I want to do a show that says, listen, do you love movies? If you love cinema, come in, and we're going to celebrate.
So what do? They bring Beyonce in. Is there anybody who's more like I'm the cool kid than Beyonce?
More inside than Beyonce.
Yeah, there's more.
We are bringing Beyonce, Billie Eilish, Reba McEntire, and Sebastian. They're all performing on the show. I cannot wait. Reach out to Van Morrison. His schedule won't allow.
Oh, my God.
So,
is there anybody? Billie Eilish? Seriously? Like Beyonce?
This shows you how inside it is. I have no idea who he's talking about when he says Sebastian.
Unless Sebastian Maniscalco.
Yeah, Maniscalco. That's the only Sebastian I know. Yeah. So when you say we're bringing Sebastian in, sorry, you lost me. You pretty much lost me at Billie Eilish, but I do know who that person is. Reba McEntire, I was like, okay, I listened to her songs in the 90s. And then you say Sebastian, sorry, that's not enough. Still, you're too inside.
805-543-3693, call or text. I'm just curious, does anybody have any interest in watching this? Maybe it's a good poll question. I don't know. Maybe we just throw it up on Facebook. But, I mean, and if there is, I mean, are you still connected to this? Are you still doing it? Remember, people used to have Oscar parties, and they would all get together, and they would have friends, and it would be a big deal. I think everybody's so turned off by Hollywood now. The worst ratings they've ever had last year, and the ratings continue to get worse every single year. Interesting.
It's one of those things I really don't care about.
Yeah, I don't either. I mean, it's the last thing I'll watch on TV. I would rather watch some weird documentary on earthworms before I would sit down and watch the Academy Awards or the Oscars.
Me too. Actually, my son, the other day, he was waiting outside of school. Him and his buddy found an earthworm. And it was fascinating to watch how they reacted to the earthworm. Like, my son looked at the earthworm. He's like, oh, check it out. There's an earthworm. And then his buddy Parker was like, oh, cool. And his buddy Parker just goes in for it, man. Picks it up, holds it up in the air. And my son's like, oh, I could do that too. And then he goes to pick it up, and he picks it up about 2 inches off the ground and then drops it because it starts squirming in his hands. Remember, he dropped an alligator.
Yeah.
Yeah, he dropped an alligator because it was squirming around in his hands. He doesn't like that squirmy feeling. I don't think he's going to be much of a fisher, Jeremy. Sorry.
You never know. He'd come around.
I'm sorry. Much of an angler. That's how you people say it.
Spending 4 hours in a box together every day can make you say crazy things. Don't go crazy. Jeff and Jeremy in the morning.
Here comes Dumbass of the Day, brought to you by California Diesel and RV. They can fix your pickup truck to your motorhome. They maintain company fleet vehicles as well. If that's something you're looking for, stop by and see them in Oceano, 1189 Pike Lane in Oceano, or you can follow the links at KZOZ.com.
How pathetic can some people be?
It doesn't matter anymore how cool you look, what you drive. Nobody cares. There's other cars out there with dudes in them. Girls don't care. Doesn't matter. You need to come in at an angle, man. Like, you need to be cool. Like, that's why I see British dudes with the hottest girls ever, especially in L.A. British dudes walk around with the hottest girls ever because they look regular, but then when they talk, they're like, hello, how are you doing? Right? Girls can't mess with that. Just, hello, how are you? Ah! Are you for real? Yes, I am. Quite for real. Hello. You look beautiful in this outfit you put together. I would like to take you to the library or whatever they say. I don't know. No, I haven't read all the books.
Dumbass of the Day. 93.3 KZOC.
The Bad Boys and the British are two things I will never understand women's attraction to. Like, why do they love British guys so much? Because I take a look at British guys, and I'm sorry, I think they're the dirtiest.
Yeah, right. Smelly, like, dirty.
Look at Boris Johnson's the perfect example. That guy doesn't comb his hair, and he's a prime minister. Okay. He doesn't comb his hair, but he's a prime minister, for God's sakes. Like, they're just unkempt.
I always think of Frasier, and I think of what's-her-face's brother that used to come crash on their couch. He's just a drunk. Daphne. Remember her brother Daphne? Daphne's brother, Donnie. Donnie.
I don't know Daphne's brother.
Oh, God. He was just a drunk mess.
Maybe this gives us some insight as to how dirty they actually are, okay? Gosh, this is a survey. They asked 2,000 United Kingdom adults. All right, so it's not just British, it's also Scottish and Irish as well. They asked them if they've voluntarily eaten food out of garbage cans. To that answer, 1 in 5 said yes.
20%.
If the food looks perfectly fine in their eyes, they will grab it out of the garbage can and eat it. No. Now, this is where it gets really gross, okay? 18% of those, so roughly 1 in 5 as well, surveyed, admitted to eating while actually sitting on the toilet going to the bathroom.
Wow.
More than one fifth have no problem eating in the bathroom at all. But actually, 1/5 of them have said that, yes, I will eat while dropping a deuce. I can't believe that those numbers are the same in the United States of America. Like, I know my wife, she gets ready in the morning. It takes her a while to get ready because she does makeup and stuff like that. And she'll take her coffee in the bathroom, and that disgusts me. I'm like, oh, I don't know. You're taking a beverage into the bathroom.
Oh, she's not to the bathroom. She's just sitting at the sink.
No, she's not. And she's just doing hairspray.
Yeah, that's okay.
And she's doing the makeup.
Yeah, we used to drink beer in the shower. What's the difference?
It's different. It's different in the shower. In the shower, you have an enclosure.
Yeah, but I'm sure you took that beer out of the shower, went to the bathroom sink and whatever, and you drank beer. But sitting on the toilet or going to the bathroom?
I think I would take it directly from the shower and move it to another room.
Have you ever been to the bar when a guy will walk into the bar with his beer and he'll start peeing and drinking at the same time?
Drinking and peeing at the same time. It's like, you couldn't just left that at the table, bro?
I have taken a beer into a public bathroom. I think I was at a stadium and there was a shelf and I could put the beer on the shelf when I went to the bathroom.
Well, how about this?
I know we're
giving away Fogarty tickets later on. California Mid-State Fair, your only bathroom option is, well, not your only bathroom option, but the most convenient bathroom option is a porta potty in many instances. What are your thoughts on taking the beer into the porta potty with you? Because you can't really put it anywhere else. Where are you going to put it?
I'm going to finish it and then I'm going to hold it and go to the bathroom. Because I'm an adult.
My game too.
I'm an adult, right? I can control my bladder for at least 20 minutes.
So these are the other places where the United Kingdom adults are eating. Over a quarter of them enjoy eating in a storage room at work. They'll eat in the swimming pool. They'll eat in a laundry room. And they'll also eat in the backyard in a children's playhouse.
Eat in the swimming pool? Like, that just doesn't sound easy.
And they'll even eat while working out.
Oh, wow.
Quarter of the respondents have actually got snacking in their special places, like the ones I just listed, and 30% admitted thinking their friends and family would be shocked at where they stopped to have a bite.
Gross. You people, you Germans. Is it Germans? British, sorry, whatever.
No, no,
the British.
No. British.
Gross.
The British, the Irish, and the Scottish.
You all have bad teeth.
That's what the United Kingdom.
And you're dirty and you're gross. You have bad hygiene.
But I could not imagine eating something while sitting down on the toilet. Could you imagine that?
Nope.
Like, oh, go have lunch, mate. Hold on, go take my lunch with me.
You're literally defecating in the toilet as you're biting into a hot dog or a sandwich? No way.
Spotted dick. It's spotted dick over there.
That's so wrong. That is like the most unappetizing smell. And what? I don't get it.
And we were worried about washing our hands during the pandemic. I mean, come on. Like, these people were.
I tell you,
wash my hands, mate. No way. I don't bother me. And then they take their lunch into the bathroom with them.
The one job I don't know if I could ever do, and I always say these guys, and you guys are the best, and that's the ones that have to clean the porta potties. And, you know, they go around with that truck and they rinse it out and they suck it out. They put a hose in there, you know, and they. And into a tank, and then they wash it out. You guys are amazing. I would rather do any job in the world. I don't know if there's a worse job than that job. I mean, unless you're literally crawling into a sewer, it's gross.
This just speaks volumes to how bad the food is over there. 1/3 of people, 33% of people say that they bring their own food over to somebody else's house, thinking that their food is going to be less than desirable.
There must be something in the German food area that's
German.
Good.
It's or not British. German. It's British.
What's British food?
I don't know that there is.
Don't they eat German food? I mean, isn't it?
So this is the UK. So it's Scotland, it's Ireland, and it's Britain.
I mean, I really like that corned beef and cabbage stew I made.
See, that's the thing. I think it's disgusting.
It's good.
The food's boiled. It's canned. It's gross.
Well, and it's in a slow cooker, and it's got all the flavors. It's pretty good. I mean, it's corned beef.
No,
I love corned beef. And, you know, you get all those flavors together, really good. I actually saved a bunch of it and froze it. I had a bowl yesterday. I'm still living that.
Enjoy it while you're on the loo, my friend.
37% and a half Irish in me just still loves that St. Patrick's Day once a year.
This has led to a poll question where we are going to prove our place in the preferred nation stature on the on the globe. Get over to KZOZ.com. We'll talk about that coming up in just a few. But for now,
people
of the United Kingdom.
Aha, you stinky.
The Irish, the Scottish, the British. You guys are grossing us out, man. You're Jeff and Jeremy's
Dumbass of the Day.
It's Jeff and Jeremy in the morning on 93.3 KZOZ.
Online, we're at KZOZ.com. Our podcast lives there. You can also search Jeff and Jeremy in the morning on any of your players. But while you're over there at KZOZ.com, check out the SurfNet Communications poll question.
Very simple, to the point, straightforward today. Have you ever eaten in the bathroom? Here's your options, Jeremy.
All right.
Yes, just once or twice, though. Yes, I do it all the time. Or no, that is disgusting.
I mean, no is going to be the leader. There's no way that no is not going to be the majority.
Honest?
Yes. Well, people, yeah, I don't think people can even be honest with themselves. Hopefully by having this conversation today, we have helped people get over this issue of eating in the bathroom. But I'm curious to see how many people actually do it. That means you've taken food in the bathroom.
Once or twice?
Once or twice.
I've done this before, okay? I've like taken a bite of something and then I really had to go potty. And I'd be like, oh, man, I got to go pee. I can't do it. And I'll still be chewing. I'll still be eating while I am entering the threshold into the bathroom. And then I'll swallow maybe as I am peeing. Does that count as eating in the bathroom?
If you're swallowing in the bathroom, then you're eating in the bathroom, all right?
I have to answer just once or twice, though?
Yes, I think that's totally it. Once or twice, all the time. No, I don't think I've ever taken any food in the bathroom.
If you're answering yes, I do it all the time, you're doing it like the UK, okay? You are doing it where you are sitting down on the loo and you are sitting there with a bag of chips or something like that, and you're like, oh, I feel like eating right now, mate. Or you're sitting there eating a hamburger or anything. I don't know. Fish and chips. That's what they eat over there.
I love fish and chips. But
not in the bathroom, though.
Yeah. Are there certain foods that it would be okay to eat in the bathroom?
No.
I mean, because I'm thinking of, like, you know, sandwiches, you know, hot foods. Like, what if you're running late and you've made yourself a breakfast sandwich and you're blow-drying your hair?
Now, I have done this, full confession, okay? I've been to, like, a music festival before. Where the only place where you could get any reprieve from the heat is inside of a, there's like these trailer bathrooms. It's like when they remodeled our bathrooms here at work, they brought one of these things. There's a trailer bathroom and it had air conditioning in it. And so the only reprieve from the heat was this air conditioned toilet. So I would take my beer in there with me, sit down on the toilet, like act like I was going to the bathroom, but I wasn't going to the bathroom. I would act like I was going to the bathroom so I could get the coolness of the air conditioning in
yes,
there while
yeah.
enjoying a beer. I've done that.
Yeah, I sat on the floor in one of those bathrooms in Palm Springs trying to get out of the heat because it was 104 out. But that was extreme circumstances, emergencies, right?
Did you consume anything while you were sitting on the floor?
I drank some water, I think. I can't remember. It's very blurry. According to toilettravels.com, these are the most approved foods to eat while sitting on the throne. And it's mainly all snack-based. 75% of people said snacks are the only thing you should eat in the bathroom. Chips, specifically Cheetos, according to this survey. Fruit, chocolate, candy, trail mix, or granola. See, granola looks like too much what could be going in the toilet, so I can't do that.
Cheetos, they leave that stuff on your fingers. That's disgusting.
So if you ever go into a bathroom and you're in the stall and you see orange stuff on the walls.
Yeah, know that somebody from the UK was there before you.
Jump over to KZOZ.com and throw a vote in for our poll question. We want to see where this is at. KZOZ.com, your home for the SurfNet Communications poll question.
Careful, you don't want to learn from this. Jeff and Jeremy in the morning on 93.3 KZOZ.
So there's this Brazilian singer. She goes by Poca. I think it's because she resembles Pocahontas.
Okay.
But her name is Vivian. Oh gosh, it's hard. De Queiroz Pereira.
Okay.
Did I do that right with the right inflection?
How does she spell her name? Is it P-O-K-A?
P-O-C-A-H. Oh, P-O-C-A-H. Okay. You want to take a look at her, right?
Of course I do. You said she looks like Pocahontas.
She had to be hospitalized after she refused to fart in front of her boyfriend. This happens to anybody that you're dating, right? I mean, she says she refused to pass gas because she wasn't on farting terms with the guy that she was seeing. So she would just be able to control it and did not pass gas. She was hospitalized as a result of this with severe stomach pains. She woke up about 5:30 in the morning.
I think she's a wimp. This happens to me all the time. I'm a pretty gassy person. As a matter of fact, I usually carry Gas X with me. But I had checked my my shave kit with my Gas X the last time I flew, and my luggage that got checked under the plane. So I'm sitting there, and I'm next to a young girl, probably college-age girl. And, you know, it's just two seats and we're close. And I'm like, my stomach's gurgling. And I have found a way that I can, like, reverse it. So it's down there and you feel that pressure. And all of a sudden I kind of do this kind of a pinch and a twist. And then it'll go, and it'll go right back up inside me. I won't have to pass anymore. I can usually do that three times before I have to get up. And then I get up and I go.
Maybe she was doing that.
And then I go to the bathroom. And, you know, once you're in the bathroom, then you can let it go. You open the vents in the airplane and you go. I don't know about you. Do you ever feel like you have to pass gas on an airplane? There's been studies done.
It happens frequent.
The way they pressurize the cabin and all that kind of stuff, it messes with you. Yeah. And even if you're not a gassy person, it can happen.
And that's why I won't eat before I go on a plane.
Yeah. I mean, maybe she's
like Mexican food, especially.
Maybe she's got some major issues. With her stomach or something.
She's only 27 years old.
She
should
hold a fart and not have to go to the hospital. God, everybody holds farts.
She was holding them all night long, okay? She woke up at 5:30 in the morning. And she was staying with the guy that evening, the boyfriend. And she said, hey, you got to take me to the hospital. I my stomach's killing me. And she gets to the hospital and they're like, have you been holding your farts in? She's like, yes, because I'm not on farting terms with my boyfriend. And part of the problem that layers into it as well is Poca. She got advice from TikTok on this, and people, and this sounds like the advice that you just gave. They told her to ignore the stomach pains and work through them if you don't want to fart in front of your boyfriend, because I guess that's the place you go. Don't want to fart.
Yeah, I mean, I'm twice, you know, I'm 20 years older than she is almost, 18 years older than she is. So here's the deal. You know, as you get older, you go through a lot of things in your life where pain is an issue, right? And you just learn to address pain. I think pain is all mind over matter. Yeah, I mean, it's uncomfortable and it's there, but it all depends. Some people can handle it better because they can turn it off. And sometimes those stomach cramps are the worst.
This is horrible advice that you're giving.
I'm not giving any advice at all. I'm not telling anybody to do anything. I'm not a doctor. I'm just telling you what I do. I know, but people think
just
it's
like
advice,
the person
right?
on TikTok that said, hold in your farts and ignore the stomach pains.
Well, I'm not going to fart next to a stranger on a plane. That's disgusting. See, I'm very lucky that my wife.
She's learned a lesson from this, actually.
My wife has had some really bad allergy sinus issues, had a lot of sinus infections. She cannot smell anymore, really. She can't. It's pretty funny. I can.
So you married the right
girl.
I can
let one go right next to her in bed, and she won't even know. She doesn't, you know. But
not even bat an eye, huh?
Yeah. I mean, now the trick is how do you make sure it comes out silent? And
not audible.
I've been able to figure out a way to configure and shapeshift my areas down there to make it come out silent. I don't want to get into that. It's too graphic, but you can probably use your imagination. And I'm sure, you know, we all do it, right? You get into a situation, you can want to let one go, but you walk away
she
from
says
a crowd.
That, she said in a post that, yes, it might be embarrassing to fart in front of the person that you're with, like your boyfriend, if you're not quite on farting terms
stinky
yet.
Stinky turn what's, off, too. I mean, we don't want stinky.
But
want
what's more
good.
Embarrassing is you is at waking him up at 5:30 in the morning and saying, I need you to take me into the hospital because I have stomach pains because I've been holding my farts back from you
she
for the last 24
she
hours.
She just said, I need to go to the hospital. I got stomach cramps.
No, she says the diagnosis was trapped farts, okay? That's what the diagnosis was. I'm not lying.
I don't care who are, who you're dating, who you don't want to disgust. You can always walk away. You can go to a bathroom, turn on a
that's
fan.
What I'm saying.
You can flush the toilet right. So they don't hear any noise. You can walk down the hall. You can excuse yourself.
And so she says now, from now on, she's letting them rip. She's learned her lesson.
There you go.
She's letting them rip,
let
guys.
Let fly.
If that guy doesn't like it, then she's going to move on to a guy that enjoys farting, I guess.
Subscribe to the Jeff and Jeremy podcast now on Apple Podcasts, Spotify, Google, and YouTube. It's your Central Coast commute-friendly podcast.